my children, but also you in life. My mother is here. And, you know, to sit through as many wrestling matches as she did when I was growing up in high school, I had hundreds of matches. Weekend tournaments, out-of-state tournaments. I mean, she and my dad both. And I guess she thought she could. When I graduated in 1993, little did she know that, you know, that my nephews would come along, and then Hunter would come along, so she jumps out of bleacher butt all the time. She's right back to the gym, right back to the sport where she started. It sucked them in. They're addicted to the sport, just like most of you are, or most of you will be, if you're not already. I don't want the focus to shift from Hunter's spinal cord injury to this is a dangerous sport. I know that it's scared a lot of people, but I'm here to tell you that the focus is not on injuries in the sport in general. The focus should stay on Hunter and a spinal cord injury, which almost never happens in this sport. Don't let that deter you from wrestling. Parents, don't let it deter you from letting your kids wrestle. The benefits of this sport far outweigh the risks of not just an injury, a spinal cord injury. It doesn't happen in this sport. About the only thing I got out of it was ugly ears. I got to explain to the new barber every time I get a haircut. Nothing wrong with them, just cauliflower ear. That's it. I've never known another wrestler to suffer a spinal cord injury. Maybe an occasional knee injury or shoulder injury, but this does not happen in our sport. So please, don't let this put a spotlight on the dangers of the sport or changing the rules of wrestling. Don't let it shift the focus from the injury that Hunter suffered. Again, enough this, you guys are going to receive far outweigh the risks of any injury. That's important for me to tell you as a wrestling community. It's a family. There are members of this community that pulled me through this. Not only my own family, but several people in Alabama. Hunter suffered his injury in Huntsville, Alabama. Several people. Scott Wade, the coach, one of the coaches for the Huntsville wrestling team. Fred Kemp, also a coach. If you get a chance to pull Fred aside, ask him at the time he wrestled day to day. Well, it's an amazing story. Several boosters. I want to thank Joe Demas. Sam Atkins, so many people in the wrestling community came together to wrap us in their arms and lift us up. Because it's a fraternity, it's a family. One of their own had fallen, and they lifted us up. You don't get this in any other sport. I'm here to tell you, I play football, I play basketball, I play every sport there is. And wrestling has taught me more about living and being a man in any other sport that I've ever played. I'll use football as an example. You may go back to a homecoming every now and then. You graduate, go to a homecoming, maybe see some familiar faces, and that's great. But there is no homecoming in the sport. No homecoming, because it is a family. When you go to a wrestling tournament, you see the same people you saw 20 years ago. I saw a referee walking around in the airport, putting him on the spot, Jack Faircloth. I don't know if Jack's anywhere around, but he may not remember this. Jack refereed one of my son's wrestling matches 2 or 3 weeks ago. Jack also refereed no less than 20 of my wrestling matches when I was in high school. Guys that I wrestled are coaching now. You see the same people. And you embrace these people every time you see them. That is the sport of wrestling. You don't get it from any other sport. That is what's pulling us through this. The amazing support from the community in general, but from my standpoint, Most importantly, the wrestling community, because you guys are picking my son up. Y'all are pulling him through this. It's the sport of wrestling. Again, it's going to get that out of the chair and on his feet. He is a wrestler. That's all I can say about him. I believe, and he believes. So many other people think. I've mentioned names. I wanted to bring all those guys out here with their selfies. You know, they don't want the recognition. They want to be about honor, and I get that. That's the type of guys that these children are. But they were there every night at the hospital. Every night at the hospital to check on him, to see how he was doing, to give him words of affirmation and point through. That is extremely important to me. It's those acts of kindness that pulled me out of the dark place that I was in. Because my wrestling brothers have lifted both me and Hunter up, and they're carrying us through. Another person I want to mention is Hunter's guardian angel in all of this. Heather, I know you're here. I'm going to put the spotlight on Heather for a second. Heather was the trainer who stabilized Hunter's neck in hospital. And at the time, I didn't realize the magnitude of the injury. I walked over and he couldn't breathe, and I said, son, you know, it's like you got a wind out of into your nose, out of your mouth. Heather was like a statue the entire time. As soon as she heard Hunter say he couldn't move his legs, this one was instrumental. It started with her. It could have been, and probably would have been, a lot worse had it not been for her. And I truly believe that Hunter had a guardian angel that day. That's why I wanted her to be here. She was at the hospital every day to visit Hunter. But there were so many people coming in and out, she couldn't get to them. So she just come back the next day. And she finally got a chance to see Hunter, and I walked her up. And she walked through the door. And as soon as she walked through the door and opened her mouth, Hunter knew who she was. And they got a mom. They got a friendship for life. You are Hunter's guardian angel. I can't thank you enough.
Probably don't recognize what you had in your coaches. You probably just get mad at them.